Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Space exploration has taught us a lot about the stars, our universe, and even our own planet. But what if space can make you rich? There are some elements up in space that are very valuable here on Earth. Many are found inside asteroids and can be worth billions or trillions of dollars, if we could mine them. The most expensive are platinum group metals, which are rare on Earth, but necessary for high-tech devices and electronics. Scientists think that some asteroids contain more platinum group metals than are in all the Earth's reserves. One asteroid that passed us in 2015 likely contained 90 million metric tons of these metals, worth up to $5 trillion. You can also find iron, nickel, and cobalt in certain asteroids. But the most valuable item might be water. It's really expensive to ship water up to space. Just 16 ounces cost a whopping $2,500. If there was a reliable source up above the stratosphere, it would have a lot of uses. Water is necessary for the cooling systems on the International Space Station, and it could potentially be used as a radiation shield for astronauts. But the most lucrative use is to split it into hydrogen and oxygen, the basic elements of rocket fuel. This would essentially turn a water-filled asteroid into a space gas station, allowing vehicles to refuel and venture farther away. Another potential source of water is our neighbor, the moon. And the moon has other valuable elements as well. It contains helium-3, which is extremely rare on Earth, but could potentially be used in nuclear fusion reactors, if we can get fusion to work on our planet. The total value of the moon's resources has been estimated at between $150 and $500 quadrillion dollars. Yup, quadrillion. Although space mining isn't easy, it's definitely possible, and several companies are currently working out how to do it. An asteroid's gravity is too weak to hold down a spacecraft, so the goal is to dock it like a vehicle docks with the space station. The real challenge is to figure out which asteroids are worth going to. There are roughly 1,500 candidates nearby, but they can be faint and hard to detect from Earth. Infrared technology helps us with that, but it's difficult to know if the readings are accurate. Also, even though an asteroid's gravity isn't strong, it can still mess with a spacecraft. Unlike the round moon, asteroids have irregular shapes, making their gravitational pull vary depending on where you are. Getting around these humps will take some work. Still, at least one company thinks they will be extracting water from asteroids by about 2027. And NASA's Resource Prospector mission wants to be the first to mine the moon with the hopes of launching a craft in the early 2020s. So what do you think? Should we mine in space? Is it worth it? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, then you should definitely check out our video on what space travel does to your body. That's because their bones don't have to support as much weight, and they aren't subjected to the same stresses that they would be on Earth. As a result, the calcium in their bones is broken down and released into the bloodstream, reflecting a decrease in bone density. My name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.